So I am here at a building in Kew Gardens, New York, and I'm about to give y'all a crash pad tour. Welcome back to another vlog. I'm Alexia Nicole, and I'm finally doing a crash pad tour that has been so highly requested. This is my classmate, Julio.
Hello.
And this is his crash pad, right?
Right.
Yeah. So I don't have a crash pad, so I hit him up. We're going to borrow his crash pad and do a tour.
And let's walk around.
All right, let's go.
Starting from here, we just basically set up this location just for everyone to organize your stuff, even though it doesn't seem to be that organized for now.
Flight attendants aren't always that organized.
Flight attendants are not always that organized. That is always right. But we have them place your bags underneath so it can be a little bit more organized. It's not a mess around the area. We have our closets. There's two on the outside. This apartment has three rooms.
So this is a clothing closet?
Yes. This is just how I have my stuff organized, but we have that shared closet. And they just basically put their stuff, you know, their jackets or coats, if they have their bags, if they want to hang their towel, their shoes, and just things that they might need on the go. You know, line holders are a little different from reserve people.
Mm-hmm.
Our reserve, they do have, like say, a little bit more of room. They do have a cold bed instead of a hot bed. Here is our common area. This is our living room.
We still have a Christmas tree.
We do have a Christmas tree. So here's the funny thing. We set up the Christmas tree for Christmas, of course. And then they just started
turned it into an Easter tree. Oh my gosh, it's so cute.
Now that July 4th, I guess, is the next holiday.
Yeah.
They will be changing it.
Change it for Memorial Day.
For Memorial Day, yeah.
That's kind of the same thing.
Same crowd.
Yeah. So living area, couch, kitchen table.
Pretty simple. Sometimes there's not even, depending on the crash pad, in this case, we do have a lot of line holders.
Mm-hmm.
So the max that you will see probably is like 5-6.
Five people here at a time.
In a day, and then just you will miss them the next day. This way now we have the kitchen. Just basic stuff, you know, our stuff. Things that we provide just for them to have. We do love to drink wine.
All of these are shared dishes.
Yes, all these are shared dishes, and they should clean their stuff as soon as they're done using them.
Okay.
Just in case.
Oh yeah, I see a wine rack up there.
Oh, wine. I just bought that one from Spain, girl. You know.
Fancy.
You know what I mean.
Julio just got back from Madrid, y'all.
Fancy. I'm gonna show you my room. This is one of the smaller rooms. It's a little bit of a mess now. I just got back. So this is my bed. Someone just moved in on this bed, so
it's
just coming in.
So this room has two bunk beds.
Yes.
So four people total.
And they just put their things if they want to have a little bit more of privacy.
Some blankets for some privacy.
That's right.
Okay.
And blackouts.
And blackout shades.
So whenever one of us is inside of the room, we just flip it.
And so that just kind of...
napping, either or not, just whatever the case is.
Pretty
neat.
Yeah. Some normal bathroom. And this is a shared bathroom.
this is a shared bathroom
for the entire apartment.
Yes.
Okay.
So this is a larger room we have. This one is four bunk beds, but they're all line holders.
Oh, so they're
not sure. Yeah, that's Christian. Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Hello.
Don't mind me.
And this is their shared closet. This is the bigger closet they have.
And so, a shared closet. So the largest room has a total of
four
bunk beds, 8 beds total. Yes. How often are you here, Christian?
More than I'd like to be.
Are you a line holder or reserve?
Reserve,
okay. Cool. So, what is the difference between a hot and cold bed?
A hot bed is a bed that is being shared, in this case, or at least in this crash, but just by 2 people. So there's just 2 people sharing the same bed. They share their schedules and they contact each other to make sure that they're not crashing the crash, but at the same time.
Okay.
A cold bed is just basically better for a reserved person that doesn't know their schedule, and it's here the majority of the times in the crash pad, and it's their own bed, so they don't share their beds with anyone.
And how much does a crash pad bed cost? Average price?
Average price, you will find them from $270 to, I've heard, $380 for a cold bed.
And that's per month?
And that's per month. For a hot bed, it ranges from $160 to $200, depending, of course, on the location and how many people they're gonna share the bed with and whatnot.
Are there any specific rules that you have for your crash pad?
The number one for me is just for everyone to respect their space. And of course, clean after yourself.
Yes.
I cannot tolerate getting home, because of course I consider this my home because I live here as well. I cannot come home and find the crash pad messy. So that's number 2. Okay.
So when searching for a crash pad, what are some of the top things that you should consider when looking for a crash pad?
Location. That's number 1. In our case, we have a shuttle. Location is number 1 because that way you save money in bus or train or whatnot. Price. How many people you're gonna sleep with on this? Not on the same bed, because if you get on a whole bed, of course the bed is just for you. You know how comfortable it's gonna be, and the amount of people in the crash bed, because the amount of different personalities that you find in a crash pad is incredible.
So this crash pad can hold a total of 16 people. Are there price differences for the bigger and smaller rooms?
No, because we do believe that fare is fair, so everyone should pay the same amount.
Just new person coming in,
they will get the same
set price. Yeah. Top bunk is the same as bottom bunk.
Exactly. And there's some crash pads that they do charge way more money just because you're sleeping in a bottom bed. In this case, in the crash pad here, it's just if you have seniority and you're sleeping in a top bunk bed and the bottom bed becomes available, then you can just
take it. Is there any contracts? Do you have to sign a lease for the crash pad?
I won't call it a contract. It's just pretty simple. You know, we do ask for a deposit. The deposit is refundable with a 30-day notice. Of course, you cannot mess up the bed and make other bad things in the crash pad. But it's not a contract. We don't. We live a month-to-month.
Month-to-month basis with 30-day notice.
With a 30-day notice.
Alrighty guys, so that's it for the Crash Pad Tour. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you have any other questions, I couldn't think of anything else, so if I missed out on anything that you wanted to know, you know what to do. Just comment down below and I will find out the answer to your question. Until next time, make sure you subscribe, like, and share. Bye!